Midra, upon removing the weapon holding him to the ground from his very head, has become a lord of frenzied flame, though an incomplete one, and he's ready to wield the full might of the flame against us. What ensues is a difficult battle, one that we will, eventually, come out on top of. Upon defeating him, we gain his remembrance, which sheds light on his history. As the golden barbs inflicted eternal agony upon him, Midra held fast to Nanaya's entreaty. Endure. The word was a curse. The possible rewards for trading in his remembrance tell us more. The Greatsword of Damnation is described as a golden greatsword that once pierced the body of Midra, Master of the Mance. Used by the Horn Sent in the execution of a damnation like no other. The barbs that pierce the victim from within wind gently around the blade. And the incantation we can gain is known as Midra's Flame of Frenzy. Incantation in praise of Midra, Lord of Frenzied Flame. The Lord of Frenzied Flame shall take their torment, despair, their affliction, every sin, every curse, all melted away. Yet Midra, like others before him, was too weak to become a lord. Knowing this, we can start to paint a picture of what happened to this man, and how he came to be under the influence of the flame. But first, let us take a moment to address the Lady of the Mance, Nanaya. We can find what remains of Nanaya as we explore its grand libraries. Her corpse sits alone, clutching something very tightly. The item, Nanaya's torch, is described as a torch made by attaching a dying flame of frenzy to a small spinal column. In a distant land, in an age long past, was born a man who failed to become the Lord of Frenzied Flame. All that remains of him is cradled gently by Nanaya. When Midra removes the Great Sword of Damnation from his head, he has no neck, so we can assume that this small spinal column actually belongs to Midra himself. And after he was pinned to the ground by the Horn Sent, Nanaya took this piece of her lord with her, after asking him to endure the pain and flames, so that the Lord of Frenzied Flame would not burn the land to the ground. Nanaya met her fate in the manse the same as all the other servants. The true tragedy is that it seems from their portrait that Nanaya may have been pregnant before this punishment was passed down, and there's nothing that tells us what may have happened to her child. Some speculate that this child may have been married, but I'm not quite convinced. I won't discredit this theory as it's much speculated, but I believe if this were the case, we'd have been given something more to confirm it. That said, the mystery of Nanaya's pregnancy cannot truly be solved. It's another tragedy in a world full of tragedy. While many have speculated that Nanaya was a deathbed companion, possibly a maiden of the three fingers leading Midra to madness, I don't believe this is the case. Anything we read of Nanaya paints her in a much more benevolent light, as a lady who cared for her lord, and wanted nothing more than for him to stay strong, so that he might spare the world. As for Midra, it's clear that the Horn Sent Inquisitors are the ones who put a stop to his transformation by piercing his skull with the Great Sword of Damnation. But what got them to this point? His servants and colleagues in the manse seem to be Horn Sent as well, so I don't believe this was a matter of prejudice. We also see how his servants were tortured, and had no idea why any of this was happening. I have a theory on how the situation started, and it comes back to a torn diary page we can find during our investigation. A discarded page ripped from the diary, bearing a passage written in a tremulous hand. I touched him, but only once. When he thrust his staff in my face, I brushed it aside. It was then that I touched him, the aging untouchable. Not only does this letter tell us how to fight the aging untouchables, I believe it also gives us insight into how Myndra became a victim of the flame. The Abyssal Woods have clearly been dealing with the effects of the flame for some time. So what if Myndra was not the initial cause? We know from Ymir's questline that the Fingers are fumbling for meaning the same as everyone else. So perhaps this land was touched long ago, and Myndra took up residence here to study the flame, look for a way to stop its effects. This would explain how the Sage working alongside the Horn Sent would eventually be attacked by their Inquisitors. If it was his job to stop the flame through his research, and he instead unwittingly inherited it through his study of the aging untouchables, that would get the Inquisitor's attention. Something that Command was once seen as an asset to the Horn Sent was now nothing more than another heretic. One that they needed to put a stop to. I don't believe Myndra had any grand plans of becoming the Lord of Frenzied Flame and bringing the world to its knees. I believe this scholar simply fell too deep into his studies, uncovering cosmic truths, and he got careless. In his interactions with those wholly controlled by the flame, he too became tainted, and rather than accept his fate, he chose to heed the words of his love, to endure the burning of the frenzy, and instead keep it locked deep within him for as long as he could. In this time of enduring the flame, Myndra would grow weaker and weaker, essentially making it impossible for him to become the true Lord of Frenzied Flame. Ultimately, our tarnish coming to the manse and allowing him to release the flame was a mercy on poor old Myndra. Not only could he finally let go of his pain and suffering, but we could see to it that this incomplete lord never rose to power, effectively putting Myndra's spirit to rest. That is, if it wasn't burned up by the very flame that kept at bay for so long. Thank you for joining us for this exploration of Myndra and the Abyssal Woods. What do you think of our analysis of this area and the Lord and Lady of the Manse? Do you believe Myndra was an innocent bystander, undone by his own attempts to free this land from the flame? Do you think he was seeking this power? Was Nanaya truly a lady of good standing with a caring heart for her people? Or do you believe she had darker intentions? Do you believe this Lord of Frenzy's Flame has any ties to Marika? And if so, why do you think that? Let us know your thoughts and theories in the comments. And please be detailed, because I am very curious. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell, and set notifications to all so you never miss out on any of our lore dives. We look forward to seeing you again for more Elden Lore.
in that way.
Thank you.
Oh. God, I jumped down here for that. I don't need that shit.
Thank you.
dagger.
I
Holy shit.
Wow.
Get
down there. Thank you.
close. Thank you.